Hi, I'm John Frizzell, and I wrote the score to Henry Poole Is Here. As a kid, I sang in the choruses of opera companies, and I did that until my voice changed, which was a sort of a sudden end to that career. I played in rock bands in high school, and then I went to USC Music School, then Manhattan School of Music. Went to work in a recording studio and ran a Synclavier, the first digital music workstation. And it was from that I got to work with Ryuichi Sakamoto on the first project where I orchestrated for him on a miniseries that Oliver Stone made called Wild Palms. Really strange thing, very cool show. And from there I met James Newton Howard and I moved out to LA. And James helped me get going. And my first two scores I wrote, a movie called The Rich Man's Wife with Halle Berry and Dante's Peak. James wrote a theme and then I wrote the score. And from there it led right into Beavis and Butthead. And then strangely, right after that was Alien Resurrection, which I try to draw the line there. I don't really get that one. But and ever since Alien Resurrection, it seems like the path has been pretty much dark films. You know, intense stories, with the exception of Office Space thrown in there in the middle. I got involved with Henry Poole Is Here just before they started shooting. Mark Pellington and I have a mutual friend, and Mark sent me the script to read it, and I read it and was just knocked out by it. The only important thing on the film was heart, was emotion, was to feel, was to understand what these characters are going through, how their belief systems were being challenged, how their structure of what was true, how their love was evolving for each other and finding out new ways of what that word really means. And that was the mandate. That was what we focused on at any turn on the film. Interpreting emotion and music, you have to end up in your gut. You have to listen to that little voice down here. And then you use what you know as sort of a tool for it. If you flip it around the other way, it gets all out of whack. So you have to use your tools up here and just listen very to that little quiet place. And that led me to find some interesting combination of instruments. We used a duduk, which is a Middle Eastern wind instrument, an erhu, which is a Chinese violin, and a traditional Western violin. And they all have a bit of a vocal quality. And the idea in the score is this voice of these three instruments woven in and out of each other. It comes back over and over, almost like someone singing. And that's sort of our unifying idea, that it expands over the whole world. It's a universal idea. It's not world music, but it has a universality to it. That's what Mark and I really came up with as a concept. I try never to use a sample to replace something. You know, so definitely in this situation, we working with soloists, taking a lot of basic ideas, improvising on them, let them grow a little bit, then taking the audio back into Logic and manipulating it under those very tight ability to control exactly what it's doing. And so I like to, again, blur that line between electronic and acoustic, start with very organic performances, and then get them into the computer, getting into an environment where I can craft them exactly to what the director wants in the film. I'm done with the film when it's on DVD. I will literally have finished cues and come to the dub stage with a new idea. Until I've explored every possible place that a scene could go, and if I wake up in the middle of the night and have a little idea, I usually feel compelled to flesh it out to see if it contributed more. And so for me, I like to write through the whole film. I think early on in my career, as I think a lot of composers tend to do, is you score scenes. But a movie isn't a scene. You have to stand back. And so I spend a lot of time getting a whole draft of the score, watching the film, bringing in some people, sitting down, viewing the whole arc. I'm much more interested in how the whole shape works than the individual scene.